Carl stood up at the council meeting because he said, you know, you had let him know that there was going to be a resolution or whatever it's called, that Catherine Elkis White was going to have a street named after her. Is she significant to your family?
No, I just I remember her living in town here growing up. And I remember going to her house before, because Relief Engine Company used to do for a fundraiser, used to pick up newspapers like you saw in one of the pictures. And they continued to do that until maybe when it became mandatory recycling, where everybody in the towns took over. We always picked up newspapers, and I remember going to Catherine Elkis's White House and picking up newspapers out of her garage. That was only one of the areas we went to, and which is up there off of where the Presbyterian Church is. It's down below that. There was a road there that drove up to our house.
Up Tower Hill?
Right. Up Tower Hill, Presbyterian Church, you make a right turn. You go down the road to our house. And now it's Ambassador Drive. I mean, you come up the other way, and her house would have set way in the back. And I remember when I was in the police force that one time, I had to go stand at the Count Basie, well, it wasn't Count Basie Field, and it was the athletic field, wait for a helicopter to come in, because I think one of the governors was flying in, going to her house and everything. So that's when she was ambassador.
She was an important part of Red Bank history in the 50s. And I was, Rob pointed out one day that there was nothing named for her in town. And of course, me being the loudmouth of the family, started to do some research. Kathy Lou looked up Catherine Elkis White, and we established the fact that we knew she was the first female mayor and the only mayor, female mayor Red Bank ever had. She was chosen to head the highway authority that built the Garden State Parkway, the first female ever to have a title of that nature. Lyndon Johnson, President of the United States, nominated four women, the first four women, to ambassadorship, of which she was one of them, to become ambassador to Denmark. So we decided there should be something done. And in October, 2 years ago, I went before the borough council and brought this up. And they all agreed that it was an oversight that should have been done. And they wanted to name something for her, but they didn't know why. And it's taken this long, and like I said at the council meeting last night, I, beyond all expectations that I had, that that beautiful piece of land at the end of Wharf Avenue, that circle, was going to be named Ambassador Catherine Elkis White Circle. I was looking just to have a name above Ambassador Drive, that people would understand, why is it called Ambassador Drive? Because, and the borough went full bore, and I'm ecstatic that she's going to be recognized here in town. And I hope that every time somebody goes down Wharf Avenue and sees that name up there and wonder who is she, goes and takes the time to read the plaque that's going to describe who she is. But she was an important part of Red Bank in the 50s.